Welcome back to the channel. You're tuned in and watching for the overview on the latest offering from the Kershaw Kai US factory in the launch series. Here is the new Launch 13. This being model number 7650, it has some very unusual body lines, aesthetics, and design cues. Following a stealth slash tactical scheme, the 13's handle is all black, with the exception of the white US flag printed on the lock side adjacent to the pivot. Due to the lightweight build and the look of the handle, I thought it was possibly Kershaw GFN, but the 13's handle is actually comprised from aluminum, then heavily machined, giving this skeletonized appearance, and also undergoing its black anodization process. If it was in an attempt to save a vast amount of weight, the extensive machining paid off. Coming in at 2.4 ounces really is an awesome feat, with the handle being 4.5 inches in length. This build reminds me of an Eon Flux weapon from the future. From just about every angle, you can see clear through the majority of the handle, which kind of looks like an empty shell when the blade isn't tucked behind it. The decorative pivot, per the Kershaw website, is shaped like a triangle that sits proud of the rest of the frame, which some may think that this is the button to fire the blade. It's not. The deployment push button looks like three circles surrounding one another, kind of like a bullseye, and this push button is all black. The 13 sports a deep carry clip that is right hand, left hand, and located at the rear is the integrated lanyard slot that is formed into the frame and created when the handles are assembled. And this brings me to the push button deployment and action upon firing the blade. Unlike previous models, the round button doesn't feel gritty and crunchy directly out of the box. The slender blade flies right out of the handle with a quick and crisp lockup sound. The blade is comprised from CPM 154, and coming in at 3.5 inches in length, the Warrencliffe style blade sports a two-tone DLC and satin finish, with a high swedge line accompanied by a flat grind. The overall length of the build comes in at exactly 8 inches. The blade's upper swedge portion has two different sections. The first, breaking away from the flat grind and tapering down until the spine. The second section is actually the flats that have been milled and reduced, resembling the bottom half of a fuller that continues up until the spine, where located in this section is the only jimping on the knife, period. This flat jimp semi-fuller area is in black DLC, as well as the top side of the spine. Very snappy, efficient, and although lightweight, the 13 still packs a heavy punch. Balanced in hand, and the button is reliable and responsive. And the great ergos allow for any and all grips to be performed naturally. Now for some people, one-handed closing can seem a bit awkward. I usually roll the knife spine along a soft surface or across my pant leg for quick one-handed closing. The index to thumb closing can be pulled off, but I've always strayed away from that one. In conclusion, I must say, I've long been done with autos due to the lack of retraction action and having to fight against the spring to put my blade up, which I can definitely say assisted openers is why I feel this way. But with this sleek little design, I could get used to hitting the push button again, and with this blade being lighter and thinner than all of my previous autos owned, closing the auto by the blade doesn't give much resistance, honestly making me want to pocket an auto again, particularly the 13. And this unit is available at the brick and mortar store, The Blade Bar, which can also be ordered online at thebladebar.com. So please rate, share, and comment down below with your take on the brand new Launch 13 by Kershaw Kai USA. And with that, I'm signing off from the Fuller Fanatic.